What's good, y'all, man? In this video, we're gonna be reacting to a NBA trade machine for John Collins. Now, I'm not really gonna be reacting to this video, but just like the trades that he shows. Shout out, what's his name? Sports Logically, I'll leak. I can't speak. I will put his link in the description. Another thing I want to say before we start this video is John Collins will not be traded, because a lot of people don't know this, or they don't follow like the inside reporters, but there's been reports that in the Zoom calls with the owner and like the players, like we're trying to get an extension with John Collins, so he's not going to get traded. But even though people think he's going to get traded, he's not, because there are also reports that Gallinari knew he was going to come off the bench and had agreed to it before he signed the contract, so there's really no point in trading him. But I mean, just for the fun of it, Hawks fan, I'll react to these and see if these are good trades or not. All right, first trade we got here. I hate the idea of trading John Collins. Oh, that's a Hawks fan, okay. But it has to be done, and things don't work out in Houston. Trades should be illegal before the trade deadline. So the Hawks get James Harden, okay, for Tony Snell, John Collins, Kevin Herter, DeAndre Hunter, and 4 first round picks. Now I'm trying to think of a lineup. Okay, so the lineup would be Trae Young, James Harden. I'm assuming Reddish. We can't have Bogdan at the 3. That would be horrible defensively. Reddish at the 3. Gallinari. Capella. And then off the bench. Or we could have... Yo, if we had Dunn at the 3, that wouldn't actually be bad either. But off the bench, Rondo, Dunn. Bogdan. I'm assuming they put Onyeka at the 4 and Bruno at the 5. I'd actually like that. I'd actually like that a lot. But that's too many firsts. That's too many firsts. Honestly, give them the OKC first, because that's going to be good. Give them our 2023 pick, and let us keep the other 2 picks. Because, I mean, James Harden's still already in trade rumors, even though, like, the Rockets don't plan on trading him. He still wants out. I don't think we have to give up that many picks, or even just, like, one less. Let us keep our 2025. But, yeah, I'd actually like this trade a lot. I actually think this is a good trade. And the Rockets, you know, they get an actual rebuild in John Collins, Herter, Hunter. And I don't really mind giving up Hunter too much because, I mean, we have Reddish. I think Reddish would be the better of the 2. Okay, next trade. This looks terrible. Okay, it's the Hawks and the Celtics. The Hawks get Carson Edwards, Grant Williams, 2 second-round picks, and a first-round pick that is lottery-protected, which doesn't make any sense. The Celtics aren't... Why is it lottery protected? The Celtics aren't making it, like, they're making the playoffs. Okay, whatever. This is so dumb. But okay, so that package just for John Collins. This is an easy no from a Hawks fan. I'm not a fan of Grant Williams. And then Carson Edwards isn't getting playing time. 2 second round picks and an 18th pick for John. No, we can definitely get better. If I'm the Celtics, yeah, easily. Even the Celtics, would they really do this? You can't put John Collins at the 5. He is horrible defensively at the 5. So it'd be Kemba, Jaylen Brown, Jason Tatum, John Collins, and Tristan Thompson. That's terrible defensively. You can't have both your 4 and 5 being bad defensively. It just can't work. Okay, next up we have the Hawks trading... Wait, hold on. I need to read the description real quick. Hawks get a nice piece in Collins and a young wing in Little. Blazers get a nice forward who I think is going to go along well with Lillard. Like, what is this? Wait, is that? I can't tell what his profile picture is. I think that's Clippers. Is he not even a Trailblazers fan? That's so dumb. Okay. So he actually thinks this is a good trade. Zach Collins, I mean, he's cool. I don't see too much of him besides him being a stretch 5. Nasir Little hasn't really shown anything so far. 6'5 power. Does he play power forward? I'm playing small forward. And a second round pick. Yeah, I don't like this. I mean, if I'm the Trailblazers, you easily do this because you already have Nurkic, great defensive center. You get John Collins. That's an incredible fit. I mean, you have to put Melo off the bench. And would Melo want to play off the bench still? I don't know. Actually, no, I did see in a JJ Redick podcast, he was willing to go off the bench. There was some other things that he didn't agree with his past teams. But yeah, this is definitely a no from a Hawks fan. This is a terrible trade. Okay, our next trade is... Wait, hear me out. The Bucks do this trade because if Giannis leaves, they sign online to the max and overpay just to keep a top 5 roster in the East. What is sign online? Whatever. The Hawks do this for Dante, who is a perfect fit alongside Trey with his off-ball movement in defense. Dante's 23, John is 22. Okay, so John Collins for DJ Wilson, Dante DiVincenzo, and 2 second round picks. So DJ Wilson, in my opinion, has literally no value. So are they saying John Collins is worth just as much as Dante? 2 second round pick, that doesn't mean anything. I'm sorry. Second round picks are legitimately worthless, in my opinion. Nah, I don't like this either. And even for the Bucks, like, if you do this, you literally have to run Brooke Lopez off the bench. And I don't think Budenholzer is willing to do that. I don't think Giannis is willing to play the five. I think Giannis needs, if he wants to thrive, he needs to play the five, and definitely pairing with John Collins. These are terrible trades. Do they not realize John Collins is a 20-10 player, shoots amazing from the field, 40% from three, and can, like, people, like, there's this fake little rumor that John Collins is just this horrible defender, and that's why his value is so low to other people. But he's not a bad defender at the four at all. I mean, he's like below average probably, but he's not a bad defender. At the five, yeah, he's terrible. You can't play him at the five. You just can't. But let's go to our next draft. I think that this might be the last one because there's not too much time in this video. Okay, here it is. Okay, so if you guys see him, like, moving, my bad. But this is how for some reason, you put it at the bottom. Since this team despises defense, Hawks get Culver Okogie in a 2024 pick, and Timberwolves get Collins. Hawks get Culver Okogie in a 2024. Okay. If that pick is unprotected, I'm actually down with it. I like Okogie defensively. Culver can still be developed. I mean, people are overreacting about his rookie year. And a 2024 pick, I don't think the Timberwolves do this. I would like to do it as a Hawks fan, but Timberwolves, I mean, let me pause because you don't need to see it anymore. Your starting lineup as the Timberwolves, I don't know what they're going to do. Like, they have such a weird roster. I think they're going to do D'Angelo Russell, Anthony Edwards, Malik Beasley, and then a power forward, and then Karl Anthony Towns. But if they get John Collins, this is the worst defensive lineup ever. Collins and Towns as your front court. Well, and I guess Malik, who are they running the three? Especially with this trade, who are they running the three? But, and then Anthony Edwards, he doesn't try on defense. D'Angelo Russell, he's not a good defender. That's terrible. I'm not gonna lie, that's actually terrible for both teams. Because how much playing time is Culver actually getting on this lineup? I don't think he gets that much. So he's not actually gonna become developed. Yeah, I don't like this. I don't like this trade at all. Okay, since those trades were actually horrible in the video, I'm gonna actually go looking. He tweeted this out, so I'm just gonna go through his replies and see, like, the best ones. But before we go through the best ones, I was just looking at the top. I want y'all to read this one. Rudy Gobert for Clint Capella, John Collins, Brandon Goodwin, the 2022 OKC first, that's gonna be amazing, and the 2021 Hawks first top 8 protected. Jazz gets players that better fit to Mitchell that are more affordable. Hawks get an elite rim protector that are probably willing to pay up. You know what? You guys should just know why this is a bad trade. I don't have to say anything. This one is John Collins for Cody Martin, a lottery protected 2021 first and a second round pick. Okay. This is interesting. Straight up John Collins for Derrick Rose. No. Straight up John Collins for Derrick White. Still no. Okay, now it's getting ridiculous. John Collins for Mike Scott in 3 first as if we're trying to start another rebuild. I don't understand this. See, I would read this trade, but in my eyes, Cam Reddish is untouchable because I think he's going to be amazing. So this could be a good trade, but I'm not looking at it. John Collins for Kelly Olynyk, KZ Okpala, and a 2022 first. Yet I'm not entertaining these. Finally, one that decently makes sense. Now the cap didn't match exactly, but John Collins for at least Mikal Bridges and, like, maybe a pick. Or I don't even want Sarge. If we can get Mikal Bridges and, like, a pick or two, I would love that. I'm not even first round pick. I'm not entertaining this either. I wouldn't hate this at all. How come all the ones that I like failed? They have to make this cap match somehow. I don't get it. This trade where the Hawks give up just John Collins and get Norman Powell, Patrick McCaw, Aaron Holiday, and Matt Thomas as if we don't have enough depth already. This is hilarious. Now, if Jonathan Isaac wasn't so injury prone, I'm just looking for all these trades from a Hawks aspect. I'm not gonna lie, this would actually be a good trade, but that's actually all of them I could find. I can't find any more good trades. So that's gonna be the video. If you liked it, subscribe. If you didn't, I mean, you can still subscribe. I have big things planned, trust me. If you subscribe, I have big things planned for the NBA season. I'm gonna make an official announcement about how it's all gonna work probably like a week before, but like the video, and I'll see you guys next time.